Hey everybody, this is social media producer Tom Barnes. This is the Chicago scene, and the Chicago scene has given me access to parts of the city and restaurants and stuff that are very Chicago, very unique. This particular Chicago scene episode has us in one of the oldest cemeteries in the city of Chicago and one of the biggest mass graves in the world, particularly on the Western Hemisphere, the biggest mass grave. I am in the Greater Grand Crossing neighborhood at Oakwood Cemetery, and I have a friend of mine, Jessica, who wrote Secrets of Chicago. And hi, Jessica.
Hi, Tom.
You wrote a story or a part of your story about this particular area. Why don't you explain where we're at and the significance of it?
Sure. Well, we are at the largest mass grave in the Western Hemisphere, which many people will be surprised to learn is down at Oakwood Cemetery on the south side of Chicago. As you know, there are no Civil War battles fought in Illinois, but this is a really big part of Civil War history that happened right here in the city. So Chicago was home to a Confederate prisoner of war camp during the Civil War. Now, it was called Camp Douglas. It was located in Bronzeville. It was named after Senator Stephen Douglas, who donated his land to be used for the camp. Initially, it started out as a Union Army training camp, and many soldiers enlisted there, including some African-American soldiers from the B and C companies of the US 29th. And eventually throughout the war, the other prison camps were getting overcrowded. They needed more places to put their prisoners of war, so they converted it into a Confederate prisoner of war camp.
So this is the Union's, it was a Union camp up here in Chicago that captured prisoners of war from the Confederacy.
Yes.
Put them in prison camps, and then because of the conditions were terrible, right, they ended up in this mass grave, which is, I mean, it's morbid, but it's true, right?
Yes, that is how they ended up here. So the camp had poor conditions. It was built for about 6,000 people and ended up about 12,000 people. So they had poor sanitation, swampy conditions, and a lot of people got really sick. It was nicknamed 80 Acres of Hell, so you can imagine it was not a great place to be. And it was actually the deadliest Union prison camp of the war.
Man, I mean, that is some morbid history. And I think it's the kind of history that most people don't even know about that happened here in Chicago. I mean, it's an impressive memorial, and it kind of is a stark reminder to the past. So much so, I mean, it has the names up on the memorial, and it's some of this says 6,000. We've read some things that say 4,000, but nonetheless, there are names of the people that passed here.
Yeah, these are all the names of the people who died in the camp. So these are the Confederate prisoners of war who died in the camp. Over there, we just saw the graves of Union guards at the camp who were unknown who died there. So we have Confederate and Union soldiers here buried side by side on the south side of Chicago.
And it just, you know, I'll just take a look here. And when you look around, I mean, it's a bustling area around us on the south side of Chicago. And this is very much a serene atmosphere. And they are paying homage to the time that this was built with. I mean, there's cannons behind us. And then there's even a wall of, or a monument of, cannonballs.
I mean, yes, I believe the cannons and the cannonballs were donated by the War Department. And they also have a cenotaph or a marker that's dedicated to Southerners who stood with the Union during the war.
And there's other notables that are buried in the cemetery. I mean, there's a lot of Chicago and world significance in this cemetery. Why don't you mention some of them again?
Yeah, sure. I think this is a difficult chapter of history to confront for many reasons, but Camp Douglas was located in present-day Bronzeville, which of course became a prominent commercial and cultural center of African American life. So there's, you know, this juxtaposition that's pretty challenging there. And in the cemetery itself, there are many iconic African Americans, including Mayor Harold Washington, Ida B. Wells, Jesse Owens, and Thomas A. Dorsey, all at rest here. You know, along with Confederate prisoners, Union guards. So it's a challenging story to tell, but I think even though we're in the land of Lincoln, we have lots of dark chapters to confront ourselves.
The rest of America, right?
Of course.
For people who want to maybe read a little bit more about this in your book, name of the book and where they can find it.
Yes, it's called Secret Chicago, A Guide to the Weird, Wonderful, and Obscure. and you can find it at secretchicagobook.com.
Well, thank you, Jessica. I'm going to swing this back this way. If you have something that you would like to see on the Chicago scene, let me know, tbarnas@wgntv.com. Thanks for watching, and hopefully, well, let me put this back this way. Hopefully, you learned something that you didn't know about Chicago. Thanks, Jessica.
Thanks, Tom.
Yep.